this Gimp workshop, we're going to make a pop art image in the style of Roy Lichtenstein. We will use the standard Gimp options and we will work with the mouse. Go to File and click Open. Search for your image and open it. When you want to use the same image as in the video, you can find the download link in the video description. If needed, we can go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Name it White. Make the fill type white. And click OK. Press Ctrl-Shift-N once more. And name this layer Transparent. Make the fill type Transparency. And click OK. Click and drag the white layer below the woman layer. Make the transparent layer active. Now we go to the toolbox and we click on the paintbrush. We change the brush to hardness 100 and we make the size 10. Back to the toolbox and now we activate the ink tool. Here we make the size 40. At the shape, we grab the square inside the circle and we move it around until we have a medium-sized oval shape, more or less like so. Again to the toolbox, and now we hit the Path tool. We will make a path around the outline of the hair. Zoom in and or out by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. Because we will stroke the path later on, it's best to start here. This is because when the path is closed, the lines will eventually be thinner at the starting point. Click the first node. Then click the second node, but hold the mouse button down. Move the mouse to drag out the handle and to make a curve. Now we can let go of the mouse. Click and drag the handle back to its node. Click the next node and again hold the mouse button down. Drag out the handle and make the curve. Then let go of the mouse. Now click and drag the handle back to its node. In this way we can make the path. We can do this loosely and make nice flowing curves, but when we are at the face we need to be precise. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more steps, and with Ctrl Y we can redo them. Press and hold the mouse wheel down and move the mouse to move the image. We can skip the details and we can also ignore the bracelet. Now we're going a bit fast forward. When we are back at the first node, we hover the cursor over it. Then we press and hold the Ctrl key, and when we see the chain icon, we click to close the path. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. It's important that the area of the hair and the arm touch each other to get closed areas. We can still click and drag nodes if necessary. Now we'll make some curves and curls in the hair. Press and hold the Shift key, and then click a node. Let go of the Shift key, click the next node and make some curves. Press and hold the Shift key again to click a new node and make a new curve. We can do this until we think it's enough. Click the button Stroke Path. In the dialog box, we check the option Stroke with the Paint tool, which is the paintbrush. Make sure that the option Emulate Brush Dynamics is checked. Click Stroke. Again hit Stroke Path, and now we choose in the drop-down menu the Ink tool. Click Stroke again. We can click on the eye of the model layer to make it invisible for a moment, and that way we can see how we're doing. We first stroke the path with the paintbrush, because the lines of the Ink tool are too thin at the begin and the end. But stroking with the Ink tool gives us the nice irregular lines. And because we have made the shape oval, the line thickness varies. Now hit the B key so we can make a new path. We're going to make a path around the arm and the neck of the model. It's best to begin here by the hand. When we are at the hair in the neck, we press and hold the Shift key. We can now click a node on the arm where the chin is. Let go of the Shift key and make a line through the hair to make a nice curved jawline. Again, hold the Shift key and click a node where the line of the shoulder and the arm must start. Then make a path to the hair, like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Now hit the button Stroke Path and stroke the path with the paintbrush. And again, hit Stroke Path, but now we stroke it with the Ink tool, like so. Click the woman layer off and on to see how we're doing. Hit the B key to make a new path. Make a path where the eyebrow is. When we make a path in the shape of a line, without closing it, and stroke it with the Ink tool, the begin of the stroked path will be thicker than the end. We can use that effect in our image. Now we stroke the path again, first with the paintbrush, and then again, but now with the Ink tool. In the next step, we will change the settings of the paintbrush and the Ink tool. Click on the paintbrush, and make the size 5. Then click on the Ink tool, and here we make the size 20. Again to the toolbox, and now we hit the Paths tool. Zoom in to the strap of the dress. Move, if necessary, the image by holding the mouse wheel down and then moving the mouse. Now we make a path like shown in the video. Move to the nose, hold the Shift key down, and click a node. Then let go of the Shift key and make a path. Again, hold the Shift key and make a path at the nostril, like so. Stroke with the paintbrush, and then with the Ink tool. Hit the B key. Make a path around the upper lip. Start in the middle below, like so. Stroke this path also. Hit the B key and make the path around the lower lip, starting in the middle at the top of the lower lip. And again, we are going to stroke the path. Press the B key and make a short line on the lower lip, like so. Stroke this line also. Press the B key once more, and move to the eye. Make a path around the eye from the left to the right and back. Close this path by holding the Ctrl key and then clicking on the first note. Press and hold the Shift key and click a note below the eye. Then let go and make a line below the eye. Do the same and make a line above the eye. In the same way, we make a short line in the corner of the eye. Do not forget that you can always undo with Ctrl Z and try again. Stroke the parts again with the paintbrush and the ink tool. Then we hit the B key. Make a circle for the iris of the eye. When we press and hold the Alt key, we can, by click and drag, move the whole path. This one, we only stroke with the paintbrush and not with the ink tool. Make the paintbrush active and change the size to 25. Now click one time in the eye to make the pupil. Press Ctrl+Shift+J. In the next step, we are going to color our line drawing. Make the model layer invisible by clicking its eye. Then right-click on one of the other layers and hit Merge Visible Layers. Click Merge. Go to Colors in the menu bar and to Threshold. Here we can just click OK. This removes the gray pixels from our line drawing, so we have only black and white left. Make the fuzzy select tool active. Check the option Add to Current Selection. Now we select all the areas of the skin. Hit the foreground color of the foreground background colors to bring up the color palette. Fill in the HTML notation F, D, D, 5, B, and B. Hit Enter. Then we can drag and drop this color into the image like so. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect. Now select the hair. Double-click on the HTML notation and fill in F, E, C, 4, 3, E. Now hit Enter. Drag the color from the color palette into the image. And press Ctrl+Shift+A again to deselect. Select both lips and the strap of the dress. Fill in the HTML notation F, F, 0, 0, 0 and once more 0. Hit Enter again. Drag and drop this bright red color into the image and hit Ctrl+Shift+A once more. Click and select all background areas and also the iris of the eye. For the HTML notation, we now use 0, 0, 6, 4, F, F. Hit Enter once more. Drag and drop it into the image and deselect again with Ctrl+Shift+A. Now we select the line on the lower lip and several lines in the hair. Move the cross in the preview pane to the top left corner, so we get white as our color. Drag and drop it into the image again. Deselect and close the color palette. Make the paintbrush active and change the size to 10. Make sure that white is the foreground color. Zoom into the eye and make a highlight. then move down to the mouth and paint highlights on the upper lip, like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Now we have arrived at the final step. Make the fuzzy select tool active again and select all the skin areas. Then we go to Tools and Gaggle Operation. This tool is still a work in progress, so when you encounter problems, you can always go to Filters, Distorts and then to Newsprint. In the drop-down menu of the Gaggle Operation, we choose the option Newsprint. Choose as color model RGB. We make the pattern PS square. Now click OK and hit Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. And there we have our pop art image in the style of Roy Lichtenstein. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If that's the case, please make the effort to give it a thumbs up, maybe write a nice comment and subscribe if you haven't done already. All this supports this channel. Thank you so much for watching.